Hello there, welcome to the Ogre, the old Git Reacts Reviews and Off Times Reminiscences. Today we're doing another guilty pleasure, this time Siouxsie and the Banshees and Swimming Horses. Siouxsie and the Banshees, I won't say they're problematic for me, but the majority of their material I find okay, nothing more than that, because it's just not my thing. Those of you that are regular visitors to this channel, and there's not many of you at the moment, but you'll know that my tastes lie elsewhere by and large. There are exceptions, as this is, but nonetheless, some Siouxsie and the Banshees songs have hooked me from the very beginning, and never have I been able to remove those hooks. The Banshees, not going to accuse them of resting on their laurels. They've always evolved, and along with that, every now and again they'll throw out a song which doesn't have any bear any relation to the songs they have on the same album or that have gone before. And I think Swimming Horses falls into that category, broadly speaking. This is my favourite Banshee song. And you might be surprised by that, because they have faster, more punky numbers. But this is the one which, if I was asked to name a favourite, this would be it, without any thought whatsoever. Why? Well, let's listen to it, and I'll try and explain as we go along. Bear with me while I do the fiddly stuff. That's what grabbed me from the very beginning. As I said, the initial singing there, initial phrase, was what grabbed me from the very beginning. Her voice can be quite strident, as many will know, but when she sings in that softer fashion, does that work? I don't know. But that, she's quite capable of adding a seduction in there, and, you know, it does grab you. I have to say that it is her singing that makes the Banshees for me. It's a no-brainer to some people, I suppose, but the point I'm making is the music on its own isn't enough, and another singer wouldn't work for me. It's her voice, and by this stage, the way she's honed it into such a marvellous thing, the way she emphasises and alternates between the more strident, commanding vocalisation to the more harmonic vocalisation. Another thing, while we're at it, this is a video, obviously, and we're watching a video because one exists. I wouldn't normally listen to or watch a video to listen to this song. It's always without any visual aspect, and for me that's the way it should be. A song should stand on its own without assistance from visuals. And I know that in this day and age it's a package, maybe I'm old, but it's got to be the song itself. Close your eyes, and you don't need and not need the video. Interestingly, I've only seen this video once before, interestingly, there's hints of peekaboo about it visually. Anyway, let's go. Losing my train of thought there. Lyrics. So, those of you that have listened or watched other videos of mine will know I'm not interested in lyrics. I say it time and time again. And again, here I'm not interested. Mainly, it's a moot point for most of what I listen to because you can't understand the lyrics anyway in most of the music I listen to. But here, obviously, clearly you can hear the words. But the poetry of the lyrics here has, and the rhythm in which they're delivered makes it another instrument in a sense, I suppose. So even if you're not listening to the lyrics, the impact is there. And I'm separating that from the musicality of the vocals. But those of you that know the Banshees know that even when they're upbeat, their theme is dark, and those of you know this song knows that this is a particularly dark theme. And despite that, it's not a literal, you know, it's not a literal interpretation of the subject matter. It is picturized or quite surreal, or, you know, indirect way of talking about the subject, singing about the subject. You may have your own views on that. In some ways, I think if you're going to sing about a particular subject which is particularly dark and horrific, you perhaps ought to be more direct and you know, get your message across. But I suppose the other way of that is if you are into a band like the Banshees, you will probably be looking at what they're talking about and find out for yourself what the matter is, what the subject matter is. It's a difficult one, that obviously being from coming from a way back when, a punk background, you were force fed the subject matter. This is obviously far more subtle. And thinking about it, when you, because I do know what the subject matter of this song is, when you do find out what it is, I think probably the impact, realization has more impact than if you were force-fed the subject matter. So I'm going around in circles with that, but it is a thought. Anyway, woo-hoo. That's good.
Time.
that sense she didn't really want to do that close up. Well, there you go. A guilty pleasure indeed, and one which I shouldn't feel guilty of at all. It is magnificent. I suppose, to mirror my previous sentiment about it all being about her voice, the video there is all about her. The rest of the group are obviously in the background and have no real role at all, other than the sort of looking pretty, if you want to put it that way. But what an engaging song. It's got a piano riff in. Now, normally I hate pianos in any sort of music. I struggle with it in many ways. But that was a simple, heavy piano riff, which, yeah, got swallowed up by the other music in the bulk of the song. But, you know, I tend to find piano a turn off, but they're fine. Quite happy with that. Her voice, again, it is her voice that makes this song for me. And most of my guilty pleasures do sort of revolve around female vocals, because it's clean singing. Most of the clean singing or clean song music I listen to nowadays is female based. I can't immediately think of an exclusively clean song that is a male voice, but you know, her ability to soar and invoke an emotional response is probably second to none. There are others that can do the same, but I don't think anybody has her better in that. You know, they call her the goth goddess, punk goddess in the first iteration, and all sorts. I don't sort of subscribe to those sort of notions, but you can see why people do attach that label to her. She is imperious and she is commanding in her presence, even without the video. You know, the voice alone makes you feel like you should stand still, pay attention, put your hands behind your back, and you know, stop messing about in the corner. Or you two, stop talking. Yes, you two, listen. And so she has a command of her listener, and sometimes I think she mocks a little bit as well. And she's self-aware, let's face it. On that video, there's a part where they had a close-up on her face. Now, bearing in mind she has made many, many videos before this and performed many live performances, I got the sense, and I'm probably totally wrong, that she's not entirely comfortable with the intimacy of a close-up on her face. And so you got hints, I suppose, of annoyance perhaps with the music director. I'm probably totally off the mark there, but she wasn't playing it straight, shall we say. Anyway, there are other Banshees alike, so to do like, they're not an awful lot of them. And as I say, the bulk of their content is okay. I can listen to it, but it's not my thing. But the ones that are my favourites really are favourites. You know, they're not sort of favourites amongst many, they are favourites that have stood the test of time over 30, getting on 40 years for some of them, blimmin' hell. Anyway, that was a treat to listen to again, and it does get listened to fairly regularly, excuse me. So I think that's three guilty pleasures in a row. Next time, I think we go back to something that Driller kills your ears. I'm sure you're looking forward to that. Anyway, click your bollocks if you wish, and I'll catch you all next time. Cheerio.